Okay, guys.
Hey, guys.
Welcome back.
Mic is working.
Thank you. Today,
as you guys can hear.
Double check, triple check.
Yeah.
Sean is like, I'm paranoid.
That was actually embarrassing for us.
Because so, when I was listening to it in the car, I'm like, there's no way. This sounds so bad. I was like,
why
don't
we even put it up?
Yeah. Whatever. But consistency, right? That's what we said.
Yeah. So I'm Ash.
I'm Akela.
And we are Cue the Commentary. And on this podcast, we basically discuss current events and we discuss Reddit, Am I the Asshole scenarios, which is basically people writing in to Reddit their messed up situations. And then they leave it up to us to decide whether or not they are the assholes in the situation or not.
Yeah, because sometimes, you know, you need that unbiased opinion and you can't go to your friends or the people around you because they might be the problem or you might be the problem. So we bring those issues to you because we want to hear your opinions.
So we love it when you guys engage. Leave a comment, rate this on Spotify or wherever you're listening.
Helps us a lot. This will also be on YouTube if you're listening to this in your car or while you're cleaning or doing your laundry or whatever.
I was listening to this like back when I was doing the dishes.
Yeah, I was so driving. Cute. I came back from a showing and I was like, I had like a 45-minute drive. I listened to the whole episode. And I'm like, this is kind of cool, you know?
And TikTok too.
And TikTok.
We had a recent viral vid on TikTok, which is always exciting.
It's funny because it wasn't even a scenario. It was
it was relatable. A lot of women agreed with us. So yeah, go check us out on TikTok. Cue the Commentary.
Like the past week and a half has been pretty eventful.
Yeah.
Right? Like in terms of things going on. Okay. Do you want to talk about Cassie first or do we want to talk about fucking the two girls?
We could talk about Cassie.
Okay.
Because
the way that freaking threw me for a loop.
Did you read the whole thing? Like what happened to her?
I think
so. The documents?
I didn't read all the documents. I watched like the in-depth TikToks.
I just read that he was making her have sexual relations with other men and watching it and getting off to it, which is weirdo behavior. I've seen this tweet where someone said, why is it that where there's a lot of money, there's also a lot of darkness? You know how he's a billionaire? And what makes you do evil things? And it's just
maybe it's greed.
Maybe is it because you're tired of, you know what I mean? They're tired of normalcy. Is that a word? Normalcy?
Yeah. No, I think Diddy, when you think about it, he's at the root of so many question marks.
He's so scary.
Like Tupac's death. Yeah. Kim Porter's death.
His ex-wife.
Yeah, his ex-wife.
/ business partner.
There's so many weird and shady things that he's secretly a part of and has been accused of covering up and stuff. And when I say, when they say, you sell your soul to the devil, that industry, why does Diddy, in my head, he is the devil. No, just the shit, even her he's iconic demonic. Hairstyle.
Yeah, I heard about that.
You know, where he saw it, right, on that one white girl, that super, super pretty Taz Angels white girl, you know who I'm talking about? The gorgeous white girl.
Was that it?
Yes, he saw her apparently and was like, oh, that's nice. Okay, now you shave your head. And then
she said.
And then she did it. Yeah. And there was even you go back into old interviews, where they're together and she'll just she's so quiet and we didn't even notice it.
I just thought that's her personality. Thought she's a very meek girl. And
and how sad is that?
Yeah.
And also because I also heard
it was also because she's just being submissive to him,
or she's scared. And he's completely has control over her. And I heard another side of it, which was it's also because Cassie's unreasonably beautiful. She's so stunning. And somebody was talking about it and they were saying this is kind of the dark side of pretty privilege in a sense, because we look at her life from the outside and we would never suspect that she could be going through something negative, because it just looks she's beautiful, she's getting everything she wants. You know what I mean?
That.
And I'm honestly, the way I was so shocked when I heard that, and then and then after I thought about it, I'm Kate's Diddy, he's a fucking shit.
Yeah, then it's
then I'm oh, okay, honestly, why didn't we think about that?
There's so many conspiracies
it's
about
so
that
sad,
man.
Though, I was so heartbroken when I heard that. I'm no fucking way.
Yeah, what, about Diddy or Cassie?
About Cassie, because I'm she seems so free and happy now with this guy, you know. And then
I don't know why, I just feel it took a lot for her to confess and to bring this to the public's attention. But I just feel there's so much that he's already done in the past. And I just think it's a safety thing for her, because who knows what can happen now. Am I sounding crazy?
What do you mean?
I just feel he's going to retaliate this.
On her?
Yes, on her and her man and family, whatever.
Who knows?
I don't want to speak that into existence, but there's no way he's just going to let that slide.
I mean,
don't know why.
I would hope that $30 million is not a big deal to him and just give it to her and just move on with your life.
But it's the reputation now.
But everybody has looked at him sideways for it.
But now it's everyone's like, it's like now it was like speculation, but now it's like, oh, we know what you did.
And it's like, there's like for sure, like she went through like sexual abuse. Yes.
Now it's like
she put it on the table, like everything that she was accusing him of.
You know, that was really courageous of her. Yeah. And like, I respect her so much for doing that. I just hope she's like safe and like has restraining orders and like took the proper measurements to protect herself from this man, because clearly he's nuts. You know?
I'm sure she has restraining orders. Like, it's if crazy. She's suing him, I'm just gonna hope for the best. And like, I don't even want to think that way. But again and again, we're just reminded you never know what someone is going through. Mm. It's so
didn't
crazy.
He like try to blow up he set someone's car on fire. For talking to Cassie.
What?
It was another celebrity. Who was it? I forgot who it was, but it was like another big thing on Twitter. No way. He was behind that because I don't know, they were like talking to each other. He's just evil. So yeah, I don't know.
And even his son. Do you see that?
How are you, like, it's like just
his
crazy
kids. I want to know what his kids see. Like,
he has so many kids.
No, but even what was his name? It's not Quincy. Is it Quincy? Yeah, Quincy. Yeah. He was like, he ruined, like, he took away my childhood innocence. Like, he literally said it on an interview.
Speaking of that, what he did to Bieber, people are saying that. Oh. Did you see the video? I think the same thing happened to Usher, where it was like maybe he got initiated to the industry.
To Usher or to Bieber?
To Usher, and then Usher brought Bieber to Diddy too after that, because I don't know how much of it is true, and I'm not that informed on it,
but you've seen so many videos.
They're saying that Bieber. He did some crazy things to Bieber.
Really?
And Usher.
There was like a time like not too long ago when they were talking about Justin Bieber and how like weird the industry has been to him as like from so young. Like, it's one thing to be a part of a boy band when there's like five of you guys and like you guys are kind of in it together, but he was like a solo
superstar
teen, like, you know, superstar. Like a teen superstar who got famous at what, 13, 14? Yeah. Like, he was a baby.
And if you guys were around, like, we probably have a lot of younger viewers, but if you guys were around to see the impact Justin Bieber had on our generation,
like, he was our sun,
everyone,
moon, like, he was
loved
everything
him
to
I
us.
Was so in
I
love
was
with that man.
Enamored by that white man. Mm-hmm. Like, I literally said,
I was literally gonna say any race,
like,
any race,
it doesn't matter,
loved,
like, the
had
way
Bieber
people,
fever
yeah.
And grade 8 too, like, we're like 12, 13,
we're literally babies. No, like, when you think about like the young men who came out, like him, Chris Brown, like these, like these men who like became superstars on their own at a very young age, like, I can't even imagine the shit they seen, because they got famous at a time where there was no
social media
as well. Yeah, like, I feel like people got away with more fucked up shit. Mm-hmm. Back then. Sure. Now there's like, you better be walking on eggshells now if somebody says something about you. Like, you will hear it. Like, this is the generation of people are going to stand up for themselves, and mm-hmm. they're going to say something, and they will put you on blast. So you better be careful. So everyone's kind of scared. But before, all these old resurfacing videos of Justin Bieber, it's like, how are you saying that to a child?
And like, people are blaming the Illuminati. I'm not too
the
into
Illuminati,
the Illuminati,
you know,
but
I'm going to say it's real. That's what I'm going to say.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because there's no way there's not a secret society. And you
know,
we will
find pleasure
know,
in these things. Yeah, to find pleasure in these things of like,
it is initiation. Like, there's, like, there's something they need to prove something. Like, we time and time again, like, we see weird things, and it's like, it's all around the same people. Like, I don't know. Like, mm-hmm. there is definitely a higher
something going on.
Thing going on. I
it
also
makes you
do
question
like
all celebrities now.
Yeah,
like Beyonce, Jay-Z.
No, Beyonce is definitely like, sorry,
something
guys. Something
is going on.
There is something going on. Like, we don't know, but
I still love her, and I love her music.
I like her music, but you know, like, okay, like, not too much, but like, that's why, like, certain religions tell you that, like, you shouldn't listen to music, because, like, there are vibrations in music, and mm-hmm. it's like, it's written in old scriptures. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
it's in like the Quran, it's in, uh-huh. I'm pretty sure it's in the Bible.
You're aware of the messaging
ungodly.
Too.
Yeah, like,
you
it
can
is.
See in award shows. Why are you like Sam Smith? I miss the old Sam Smith. I don't know what happened to him.
They're pandering to us too, though, because we are talking a lot about like, oh, they sold their soul to the devil. So now it's kind of like, look, Doja Cat fucking lied. She's not the fucking devil. She just came back and she's just a weirdo. Like, now I don't buy her act anymore. It's just an act. I don't buy
maybe.
It anymore.
Or maybe
Doja's being, she was doing an act because we were making fun of her. Like, that's what I think. Like, Doja's not serious. Sam
really?
Smith? No, I don't think so. And Sam Smith too. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know if they're just pandering to us because they know we're going to go crazy.
Nah, I think it's the elitist behind the industry. They are influencing them to continue making demonic trash music. Mm-hmm. I guess that's how they like keep their
trash
spot.
Is questionable though, because it do be banging sometimes.
Or are they just like industry plants? Kind Ooh. Of.
Sam Smith?
Sam Not Sam Smith now, but I'm just saying if you follow what they want you to do, you're going to like keep your spot at the top, you know? Back to Cassie. Let's finish off with Cassie. And the crazy thing is he's so quiet too. I feel
Diddy?
Like
yes.
yeah,
that's what makes him scary.
Like, he has this personality where he's like, did he love or whatever love? It's stupid. But he's just so quiet. Like, you don't know anything about his personal life, nope. really. Except for the woman that he associates himself with.
He's just
and like Young Miami.
Oh, girl. She's fucking a dark weird. Spirit. She is weird.
Weird. No. She's doing anything for that bag. And you know Diddy paid Cassie an allowance every month to hush hush. I think it was like something 200,000 or literally, crazy.
I'm really looking at Carisha sideways because why are you really with this dark spirit? You know it's just for money. She doesn't care. For money.
And like now she has a successful show on his network, Revolt, right? It's doing so good. I'm sure he like helps her with the card game and has a huge like hand in that too. Yeah. You know she has like a really good successful card game, drinking game, whatever. Yeah. So like he's making her kind of depend on him now. I think it's gonna be harder for her to leave, especially now with all these allegations and stuff. Because it's like, I mean, she should leave, but I'm just saying like now he's kind of created a dependency on him.
I don't know. I mean, definitely. That's the thing.
Again, and you never know what she's telling him or he's telling her.
Yeah, we don't know what's actually going on behind the scenes, right? So we can't actually say. But, like, the fact that she – like, now it's coming to light what he did to Cassie. But the fact that she's been with him this whole time, there's definitely been some dark shit that she's seen. She definitely knows stuff. Like, she really does give – anything for the bag. Like, she's been saying it in her music this whole time. We were just like, okay, but how far are you really gonna go?
Are you still with him, or is it a business relationship? All the uproar now, if you are still with that man, it's just like, bro.
But
I don't think she knew. You think she knew?
I just think like maybe she didn't know actually, but there's probably signs that this man is a weirdo. One, maybe his sexual desires are fucking weird.
He's, you know, she likes weird shit too, though. Don't. Said she like likes to dress up and like plays the whole, like, does the whole dominant. Yeah,
that's not that weird. That's not that crazy.
Yeah, but that's what she just admitted on her show. So who knows what else? One thing about it,
I think she's just down for anything.
Okay, enough about Carisha.
Carisha, please. And, like, actually,
I don't like that one. Let's talk about the two girls.
Oh my God.
Girl on the left and girl on the right.
No, because the way TikTok has lost their mind. Like
Twitter.
No, it went crazy on Twitter. But when I seen it on TikTok, I was like, what is this beef? And then I'm looking at, because the first one I saw was girl on the right. The one who's the shady friend.
Oh, okay,
the first video I saw.
Okay.
And I'm reading the comments and she, because I didn't get any context. So I'm like, okay, she wore his sweater. I'm like, fucking what? Like, what do you mean? And then she was talking about like, this sweater was so cute. No, I have to talk about it. Please. Like, she's like, oh, the sweater was just really, really cute. So I kept it. Okay. Mm-hmm. I got him a sandwich because he put up my TV. Yeah. Okay. But then when she said the close friends thing, I was kind of like, really, like, honestly, and sometimes TikTok comments will gaslight me. Like, I will be like, you know what? Maybe y'all are right. Like, if all of you guys are saying this is not a big deal, maybe I'm the one who's kind of, but in my head, I'm like, I don't know. Like, close friends is like, why did you go out of your way to add this girl's man into your close friends? And then a few videos later, I seen girl on the left. And then I started seeing, like, Twitter started coming out with everything. Mm-hmm. They showed us the sweater. Did you see the sweater?
Yeah,
it's just a fucking black Nike sweater.
How do you know that's a sweater? That's my question.
No, because she, like, the girl on the left came and made a whole get ready with me and did a whole bunch of outfits with the cute sweater.
Oh,
yeah, it's so funny. She's so petty. She put it, but it's just a fuck. It's literally, guys, it is a plain. It's like the standard Nike hoodie.
Yeah,
it's not even a cool color. It's just black.
It's just black. It's just his. That's what it is. Like you said, TikTok gaslighting you in the comments. Yeah, I was just like, because in her explanation, girl on the right, she was like, the night that her ex-best friend met her man, they introduced each other.
Right.
So it's just the posting on the close friends. Because, like, okay, you added him. Cool. But you posting things about, like, his favorite brand and you posting things in a thong, in his hoodie, that's where you got me messed up. Because you can add him to your close friends. You all know each other initially.
What's killing me is how people are – they're like – your best friend's boyfriend should be like either
invisible
an uncle,
to you,
like,
yeah,
like it should be an uncle relationship or like someone your you worst even do enemy. Not care about at all. Yeah. Like, and it's so true. It's like, I don't
really care.
The way I don't know, like, their last names, what their story is, what they do for work. Like, it's not my business because I don't care. Like, you know, and for her to be like, for her to go out of her way to like get this, I don't know, get the sandwich. It just gives so much bag energy. Nah, I don't know. That's really, really weird. The close friends. And then now you're posting in his sweater. And now why are you in a thong? You never post. I've been on. Like,
yeah, that's what it is. Imagine it's like what came after adding him to the close friends. Like, now you changed because you're doing things deliberately or like
it's like I've had you on close friends for years and yeah. I've never seen
she's trying to be shit slick before. She's trying to be slick and yeah. do things to get his attention and yeah. as a girl you just know when a girl is trying
100 you don't even have to be in a relationship, it's just girls can see through girls
yeah
and it's like this you know whole how act yeah, yeah. You, this whole act that you're saying like well no this and no like the yeah, little girl, explanations it's like maybe a man would believe you
yeah
but like you're actually not fooling me and you're supposed to be yeah. my best friend so how about yeah. fuck you like yeah like
actually fuck you.
And then they showed the guy mm-hmm. did you see the guy? He's gorgeous. He's beautiful. He's tall, Asian model type guy.
I was going to say a K-pop.
Like, he looks like a K-pop yeah. star. Yeah. You know? And so people are like, oh, that's why she went crazy. And then they're like, you know what, girl? I would have done the same thing.
No, I don't like that one. I don't get the people who are, like, on the girl on the right side. Maybe they think it's wrong that she cut her out with no explanation. That was a big thing. She's like, now I finally know, because she made the video. Now I know why you cut me out, like, after a year or two of, like, not being in her life. She didn't give any explanation. I just can't
like buy that whole thing. Like there's no way you didn't have any kind of inclination as to why your friend stopped talking to you. But like she mm-hmm. told the same stories just with her perspective on it, but the basis of what happened was all the same. Like the close friends, the sweater, the sandwich, mm-hmm. right? So you don't think that had anything to do with it? Like come on, you can't put two and two together.
Yeah.
You really think you're that innocent? Like be no, so no, for but, real.
Yeah. No, I'm saying why people are like on her so side. Mad and on her side. But I think there's some things that don't need to have a conversation. Even if that is your best friend, like, yeah. I just feel like that was just that you showed your true colors. Like, exactly. You showed me who you were. And I don't even think a conversation can fix it. That's just you. That's yeah, just like, who you are.
What conversation could you even have? Like, she's just going to deny it.
Yeah.
She's going to be like, no, or like, I didn't
that
mean
was
it.
Your perspective.
Yeah, like, exactly. That's just one of those things. It's like, I'm just going to take it. Shut up. Yeah, and I'm going to walk away. Like,
team girl on the left.
Girl on the left and your best friend's boyfriend, like they said, should be similar to an uncle. So just keep that in mind. Anyway, guys, let's start our scenarios.
Let's get into And now let's get into
cue the commentary. That's our little song.
Yeah. Like, we should actually have like a voice recording.
We should.
With like some like instrumentals
cue
in the background.
Cue the commentary.
Not like that. No, you don't always have to sing.
Oh, but like, you said song.
No, just like. And now let's get into cue the commentary and then like some instrumental, like a sound effect.
Oh, you don't want to sing?
It's not
just
like
a song.
Wants to sing.
Why do you want
to
sing? And it's like,
song?
Guys, okay,
it's okay.
Guys,
you
know what's so funny?
It.
So long ago,
no,
like on
no,
Ashton and Kayla, no. We actually went to a recording studio. And listen to me.
I'm so
that was a fucking,
happy that never
no,
ever came out.
No, because
out.
I wish it came out.
Me on my Snapchat stories. Like, years ago, us in the studio singing. I'm like, wow. Like,
I know the song right now.
God, I know it. I know it. Don't.
It's a good sis. We eating
no,
good sis.
In the city with my good sis. Is it in my city with my good sis?
No, it's like,
you
in
never
the city
know,
getting
you
busy
know.
Now.
Oh,
yo, wait. Let me see if God. I have it on my phone.
No, no, please.
Because if
stop.
I have it.
Stop. It was like, fun at the time. Some okay. things are like fun for the moment, you know? Like that would have been cute, I guess. But just like looking back on it, it's kind of cringe.
I definitely think it was giving like groundbreaking at the time. Like, what do you mean you guys have a song?
That's crazy.
That's what do you mean?
That's
you don't
what
think,
you think?
Yeah, that's literally what I think. I will never like anytime somebody tries to do like a creative thing, I'm never gonna knock it. No. It's and you know what? I always like I'm sometimes too far into Shauna's like kind of the opposite where she'll hold back a lot more and I'll be like, you know what, sometimes you're right, like maybe
I'm so happy, like literally
it was really like a time, like we really went to the studio, guys, like that's what you're not understanding.
Funny. Daniel Caesar's producer was working on this for us, okay, and we
like not
put
a,
it out,
like the guy was like, nah, don't worry, I'm gonna get you a good studio time, like and he really mixed it for us and it was yeah. I honestly thought it was really good and I just wish I could find it. If I find it,
I have it, but I'm not telling you.
Do you have it? Shana,
I don't know
please.
Where it is though, like
please.
It's somewhere deep in my Snapchat.
Please, please, please,
I'll send it to you.
Okay,
but we're not playing it here.
We have like, to show it to them. It was a good time anyway. But yeah, anyway, we should come out with a little jingle.
Maybe I think a jingle for the segment change.
Sure. Okay.
That would be good. Okay, should we start?
Yeah, let's start.
All right, am I the asshole for telling my 14-year-old daughter that she's average looking?
I have this one.
No, you don't.
Okay, go.
It's good.
It's a good
really
one.
Good. Okay. I, female 39, have a very insecure daughter, female 14 who has a depressingly unhealthy obsession with her looks. She often avoids mirrors and pictures because her mood instantly drains when she sees herself. She constantly asks her father and me if we think she's pretty, and we always tell her the same thing, that she's a beautiful girl inside and out. As I understand how most teen girls are with their body image, as I was one at some point myself, my daughter's vanity is not only becoming exhausting to those around her, but I fear it's causing her to slowly lose herself. Mm-hmm. Yesterday, I decided to sit her down and chat with her about this, to discuss what's bothering her and to see if she's willing to visit a therapist. She told me she didn't want to talk about it, but as her mother, of course, I'm going to be worried about her. So I insisted. She finally agreed. A few moments into this conversation, she asked exactly this. Mom, I want you to be completely honest with me. That means no sugarcoating. Okay. How are you gonna... Why are they so rude? Why would they
I don't know why. Like, read the story, please.
Okay. The kids at my school think I'm ugly and say I look like a bird because I have a big nose. Do you really think I'm beautiful, or are you just lying? I'm an honest person, so I gave her the most honest answer I had. I told her she was average looking, like most people in the world are. And that it's not a bad thing to have an average appearance.
It's giving, she hates her daughter. Like, why the fuck would she say
immediately
that?
Got up and left without saying a word and just went into her room for the rest of the night. Today, she has been cold and distant, and I think I upset her, which wasn't my intention at all. Am I the asshole?
Yeah, you upset her.
I wanted to know, like, if she's like white or like an immigrant parent, because for me, uh-huh. I was an ugly kid, okay? Like, even an ugly. Like,
but there's no
pre-teen.
Way your mom said you were average looking. Like, even
okay,
if
okay,
you were
not average looking, but hold on, can I tell
okay,
you about something?
But please.
So I had a best friend, okay, right? Her name was Aprielle. Shout out to you, Aprielle, if you're ever watching. But she did like, she had an agency and she was like modeling for Zellers and
oh,
stuff
wow.
like that.
Okay, okay.
So, stop.
I didn't even get to it yet.
So I said, Mom, I want to do that. And like, I set up an appointment. Like, my mom was like,
wait, you did that?
Yeah, of course.
You know what's funny? I did that too.
No, no. Like,
because the delusion started very young.
Absolutely. How are they going to tell me no? Like,
yeah,
they
I'm
need
perfect.
Me.
Yeah.
I want to be on the Zellers poster too. So, Zellers was like a Walmart back in the day, but they
it was
got rid of it.
Target.
It was huge.
It's like a Target equivalent.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's huge.
So, I told her, I said, can I like audition? Like, I think they'll really like me and yeah. stuff. She's like, Shauna, I don't know. Like, I don't. She's like, I don't know. I don't think they're gonna like you. No. Like, what are you? What do you mean? How are you gonna tell me that?
One thing though, your mom is sometimes too real. Like, but okay,
no, but
I'm gonna guess they're not immigrants though.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Because
I'm just saying, like, it's like it was an eye opener because
yeah.
I'm like, you know what? Maybe I'm not. Maybe they won't like me. Like,
right.
it brought me back to reality. You
really?
Know. But I was okay with that. I was just like, I still went to my audition.
Yeah, that's what I think.
I
like,
killed
it. Get knocked out.
I got measured
down.
And stuff.
Yeah.
But like, my mom was very honest with me, and she's like, I don't know if they're gonna like you.
Right.
Like, you know. But the way she said it wasn't like
you're
rude.
Out. Yeah.
Kind
like,
of. It was just like,
know.
I don't know.
Yeah. Like, yeah. Yeah. Like, you know.
But I was so confident. I said, I need to be, you know,
a
like
superstar.
That. A superstar.
I have
so.
To be superstar girl.
So sometimes like, you do have to be like honest with your kids,
but it's also like you have to read the kind of kid you have and also the kind of relationship you have with your kid. Because one thing about it is for sure my parents humbled me, but
humbled.
It's just like it was, I don't know. It's just like growing up in the household that we have, it's like it's kind of normal and it's like you don't take it so hard.
Yeah.
And at the same time, it was like my mom could say like she could humble me, but at the end of the day, she will never tell me I'm average looking. She would always tell me you are the most beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
You are like, she would always say positive things and reinforce things about like not only who I am, but like physically. Like that's your daughter.
Yeah.
Like you shouldn't say that to her, because also like when you're a kid, like you grow into yourself. Sometimes your face didn't grow into yourself.
She's
yet.
14.
Like how
I was literally
how
gonna
can
say,
you
like,
say that?
Grow
so
into your
fucking
features.
Rude. Like what do you mean? Am I the asshole? Do you hate her? Like
mm-hmm.
I would not even say, like what do you mean? You're average looking like most people.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. So I'm ugly, because if you're gonna tell me I'm average looking, what you want to tell me is you're ugly. Actually,
I
lower.
Get it. At 14, you might. Think or like take it in as that like
yeah.
you might be like, okay, she just called me ugly because average is definitely not beautiful.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? But like now my big age, I'm just like, average is still not ugly. It's just like the majority of people are average, but it's just she's 14. Like she's not gonna take it as like it's
her,
okay to
her
be like
self-esteem is clearly very low already, and what she needs is consistent positive reinforcement from people whose opinions mm-hmm. that she really
I'm just trying to like understand why the mom would ever say that.
Like that's her, what it's really it's like, not wrapping my head about you, especially if she's like, I'm gonna take you to therapy because you really yeah. need to work on this, like you need to not put so much importance on this. And also if she's getting bullied for it, like it's just not yeah, gonna help. Yeah, yeah. So like if she's getting it at school and then also getting it at home, you probably mm-hmm. like knocked her back seven steps
confidence wise,
you know.
Nowadays people on social
especially
media
now, like that's the thing, like we imagine. Really grew up like in like the in between time, like there wasn't yeah. that much social media. Like yeah, we had Facebook and like Instagram Tumblr. Was new and Tumblr mm-hmm. it wasn't to the point where it's like you really are comparing yourself so yeah. consistently.
Like, I would like talk to the principal or like
exactly
you know like, what I mean first like of all, do stop calling my daughter ugly. The kids bullying your daughter,
like what do you mean you look like a bird?
Yeah, rude. Therapy is not gonna help if you still have people at school, you spent a lot of your time at school mm-hmm. you know, constantly talking down on you. Like they deserve to be punished for that.
And then also to your point of like people are average, like yeah, there's people who might like be average to like other people, but I also genuinely believe like beauty is really in the eye of the beholder. Like obviously there's people who are like undoubtedly beautiful, like Cassie.
There's like, gonna be someone out there that's
but
like
even so, like she's whatever to somebody else, like you know what I mean. So yeah. because when you're young you really value this one standard of beauty. Like when you're younger there's more of like a you are either ugly or pretty mm-hmm. you know, but like as I get older more and more I'm like there are
open
so
mind.
Many you're yeah there's open-minded. So many unique beauties, like mm-hmm. even like I love like that trend on TikTok where they're showing like, oh this is my Iranian nose or this is my African nose or something.
Foreheads,
like, you know, like the foreheads.
Do you
like,
remember like,
no, the way they
I
used
was
to make
so
fun
embarrassed
of
my forehead.
Bro,
yes we are Ethiopian, we have big ass heads.
And my mom refused. She what? Did not know what a baby hair was. Pulled my hair back. Like
no, baby hairs were not a thing back then.
Well, not for us. Like, we didn't know about them. Especially when I grew up around, like, a lot of white kids. They yeah. fucking came for me. Yeah. Like, they made fun of my forehead, my mm-hmm. nose. Like, you get older and, like, you're
you
like,
embrace your features.
You
and
do.
You actually, like, your mind can switch. I used to hate my forehead, but now I love it.
I think
it
balances
foreheads
my,
are so beautiful.
I love it. It balances your face. Like, you yeah. have more room. Like, all that stuff.
You have
like,
more to room do stuff. For what?
I don't know. Like, eyebrows and eyelashes. Oh, okay. But, like, all of that to say, it's, like, we are able to, like, be confident now because it's, like, at the end of the day, I yeah. always had my mom
she's
telling
always
me that I
remember
beautiful.
That. Yeah, the 14-year-old
oh, she
will
never
always remember her mom said
your,
she's average
nah.
looking.
Like, no.
Just like how I'll never forget my mom said.
I don't
think
know.
So. I don't know. No. By the way, they didn't call me back. She was right. So
they called
call
me
back.
Did they?
Not for not for modeling, for acting. Because I was a really charismatic kid.
No, as a kid, you were really good. Yeah. But, like, preteen? That like the ugly
that,
face for
no,
me.
That was too ugly.
No, you weren't. You were not.
I was
you were
so
cute.
Ugly. What
you were always
about?
Cute.
No, I wasn't. Okay. I literally wasn't. No, I was so
beautiful.
No,
else.
No.
Was
so I was. Cute. I wasn't preteen there. I was young. I was
oh
like,
yeah, true.
Like
true,
I was like.
True.
Under
you
10.
Stopped like yeah. You stopped.
Oh no! On. Once I got to 12, 13, I was well ugly. Like no, my purple reading glasses.
I had my purple outfit too.
Oh my!
Purple was the shit back yeah. then. Even if you do think your daughter's average looking, lie. Like why wouldn't you just like.
But
feed
like,
her ego a little bit. Help her with her confidence.
Do you think you would? I mean, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like there's like.
I think she truly
mother's...
believed that her daughter was average looking, or
but,
else
like,
she wouldn't
I feel
have
like,
said that.
Don't moms have like
like
a mom's
beauty
eye?
Sunglasses?
Yeah,
or
like
beauty eyeglasses.
Yeah,
on?
Like for their child. Like, you are
my mom
beautiful
didn't.
Child.
So I don't think so.
No, because maybe your mom was like, I don't know if they're gonna use you, but maybe there was like a lot of reasons in her head. Like when you're not a white kid, like at that time, maybe it was more white kids. Like, what was Abrielle?
Abrielle was Filipino and white.
Okay, so that she had like Philip mm-hmm. Asian, like Asian is like white.
She was
so
also just cute.
She was like, also probably super, yeah. super cute. Like not that you were not super cute, but like you know
I wasn't though.
No,
like,
but you were.
I mean,
she
like, from
you
the
were.
Perspective.
No, you were. Shoshana
at
was
that
actually,
age.
She was such a goofy, cute
Shut
kid
the
though.
Fuck
no,
up.
You
Why
were.
Are you lying right now?
I'm not lying.
You didn't even know me then.
I've seen pictures though.
No,
I've seen pictures. My point is, it's like maybe she thought had other reasons to say I don't know, Shoshana. I 100% do not think your mom looked at you and said you are not beautiful and that's
yeah.
why they're not gonna pick you. They're for
yeah,
sure she
okay.
was not thinking that.
Okay.
You
yeah,
know what I mean?
Yeah, I was also a little overweight too. I was chubby, so
I don't even think
there's a lot of things.
I don't think that was even it. Like she probably had a lot of reasons to say that. Am I the asshole for not paying my nephew's hospital bill? I have 4 kids, Alexis 15, Lucas 12, Ronnie 11, and Ali 8. Alexis has a lot of health issues. We've been in and out of the hospital for months. Something important to note is that Alexis has a PICC line, a big take-home IV, and is getting blood thinner injections every day, so we do have needles and vials around the house. She also occasionally gets pain medication through the PICC line. My sister has 2 kids, Andrew 12 and Alyssa 9. She brought them to the house to play with my kids not too long ago. Alexis had a minor procedure a couple days before they came, and I was showing my sister a video of Alexis at the house
right after the procedure. She was still very high and it was hilarious. Andrew came into the kitchen, heard the video, and asked what it was. I said that I was just showing his mom a video of Alexis after she got some pain meds. A few hours later, the kids were grabbing a snack, and Andrew took the container with needles and vials of blood thinner out of the pantry. He asked what it is, and I said, it's Alexis's medication. My sister and I left to take our dogs for a walk, and I wanted to get a snack out of the pantry when we came back. I noticed Alexis's medicine box was moved, so I looked at it, and one of the blood thinner vials was a lot more empty than before, and a needle syringe was missing. Sister and I interrogated all of the kids, and we found out that Andrew gave himself a high dose of blood thinner because he thought it was her pain meds, and he wanted to get high. My sister rushed Andrew to the hospital and he stayed overnight. Now she's sending me the hospital bill because I was the one that left the medicine where he could get it. I'm refusing to pay because if my 11 and 12-year-old boys and 8-year-old girl know not to touch other people's medicine, her 12-year-old boy should definitely be able to see a vial and syringe and not drug himself. Mm-hmm. She's threatening to sue and I really don't want to go down the legal route with this. Am I the asshole for not paying the bills?
No, you're not the asshole. Like, that's not your son.
Why does your kid want to get high? What the yeah. fuck? What kind of weirdo kid wants to inject themselves at 12 years old? I would be so concerned. You should know
better. Yeah.
I would be so concerned. You get high. What kind of crazy reaction to that? Like, you saw a funny video. Why are you going to now inject yourself to get high? Are you crazy? I'd be like, son, are you crazy? That's insane.
Is he okay? Like, is there an update or like?
There's an edit, but it doesn't really say, I'm sure he's fine. Like, it doesn't mm-hmm. say like he got super, super sick. But I'm just saying, like, you're not the asshole. Even, like, pay me back for my syringe because that's for my actual sick daughter. Like, you know what I mean? And pay me back for the blood thinners because mm-hmm. that probably costs a lot of money, too. Yeah, I don't know. I think her sister is nuts for that. The edit is, I'd like to clear this up. This is an injection, not an infusion. All you need to do is inject it into the subcutaneous tissue, and I don't even know if he did it correctly. So my thing was like I was also thinking like you can like if an injection goes wrong like can't you like kill yourself like if there's like oxygen that goes to your heart or something like you know what I mean like the air bubbles or whatever like how does a 12-year-old like not kill himself almost from doing something like that I don't know
like, I'm sure the 12-year-old like he wasn't thinking that I can potentially harm myself, you know? I think the way that the aunt was, like, laughing about the mm-hmm. high pictures and stuff mm-hmm. kind of gave him the idea of, like, it can be fun for in sure. a way to do for this, sure, you know? Yeah. So I think he did it unintentionally, not knowing that, like, you can really hurt yourself for this. But I still don't think that she owes him or the family any money. I think that's just, crazy yeah, it's to kind even of crazy. Ask for it. It's like, it was his mistake, but it's definitely not mine.
It's definitely not mine. Like, and it's like, it's not really out for him to get. It's like, yeah. this is my house and she's a sick kid. He
went looking for it.
Yeah, like he saw it. Yeah, like literally, like what are you talking? And he's 12. He's not 2.
Yeah.
Like, you know,
12, you definitely know better. Yeah.
12, you know. So not mm-hmm. the asshole.
Am I the asshole? Because I am firmly against my wife's decision to quit her job and move towards soft life.
Isn't okay. this so funny?
Not soft life came to am I the asshole? Got it. Advice needed, he said.
Okay.
I have no idea why my post was taken down. I think it was her. I think it was the wife. Taken down and suspended from my original account. So posting this again on a new throwaway. My 32 male, wife 30 female, have been married for 5 years, together for 9. We attended the same uni. She was in computer sciences and I was more into data. This is relevant later on. We are also a child-free couple, and we split the chores and finances evenly as we both earn roughly the same. Household income is $200K. So damn. $100K each.
They're making good money.
Yep. My wife's job is stressful. She's an engineer and has to do a lot of coding. So many times, I've seen her just get lost by herself trying to figure out what went wrong with her code that she couldn't solve. She also works long hours, spending 3 days in office too. She suddenly announced today that she's going to be quitting her job to move towards a softer, feminine lifestyle. I couldn't get what she was trying to convey and asked her to clarify it to me. She has this whole ass plan of setting up a freelancer account that, although aligns with her field, is much simpler, means her income will be slashed to a tenth of what she earns.
A tenth.
As she plans not to take too many assignments. I sense some anti-work vibes from this new soft life trend. She says she feels burnt out and no longer wishes to be a part of the hustle culture and wants to enjoy the finer things in life. She said she never got a moment to think and stop to relish these things. And she no longer wants to spend her life in misery. She's been watching a lot of TikToks. I didn't even get this far when I read it first. She's been watching a lot of TikToks, but I figured. I never thought it was serious. She'd mentioned doing things like getting massages and nails done, doing a 10-step skincare routine day and night, undoubtedly expensive. Explore different home scents. Explore color theory to change her wardrobe. Investing in wine tasting, baking, and knitting.
These are not all that crazy, though.
And a host of low effort yet luxurious tastes. I've honestly never expected my wife to be so delusional. She does this whole explanation of how she wants to be the one taken care of and how I, as a provider, should take on the masculine role. She says she's okay with downgrading our lifestyle, which isn't even really a downgrade. We'll get to that in a second. And spending more time with her with the chores. She loves deep cleaning and chores in general. She finds it therapeutic. We currently live in an upscale apartment in the city. Her idea of downgrade is to move to an equally plush suburban home. She says, since my job is work from home, I should be okay. The deal is, I'm not okay with being the sole financial provider. I do not want to move places. I do not want our life still to change. When I brought up therapy, she told me she already, in secret, attended some online sessions, but didn't involve me because she wanted to make a judgment without being influenced by me. I see this as sort of betrayal, or am I overreacting that she didn't think of including me in this massive change? I sternly told her that I do not under any circumstances support this. She can easily find a job that isn't as stressful. I told her that she needs to figure herself out and that TikTok isn't reality. Wife feels burnt out, wants to quit her job permanently to become lazy. How do we work through this? Okay. Okay. I understand that your job is really stressful. Yeah. You do coding. I know there's like this whole thing about like working in tech and like you make so much money, but the reality is it's a really stressful field to be in. I get it. Every woman wants to be in their feminine divine energy and like live the soft life. It all sounds great, but I just think like there could be a compromise to this. You don't need to work maybe in that field, but maybe because you have such great experience and a great education, mm-hmm. you can find something, you know, less stressful, but still pays.
Or maybe like less hours. I don't think what she wants is wrong. And I don't think he should like completely knock it and be like, well, I don't want to be the sole provider. Cause I do subscribe to the TikTok thing of like,
I mean, like I think he got comfortable. And like, no, we make equal. It's like a 50-50. This is our relationship. Yeah, like, and that's not... I think the issue was, and I think girls of our generation or women of our generation won't have an issue with it because we're telling them up front what we want. Like, I don't want to work while I'm carrying your child. Or like
I don't want to work be a full time.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Like, really hard to like to survive off of one income in our world right now. Yes. Like, it's really, really hard, especially if you have like a full other adult to take care of and then children. It's like you have to be bringing in so much money, which is very hard for most people. Mm-hmm. But like you said, there can be a compromise, but I don't think she's wrong. And I do think he did get comfortable. Yes, you should be providing for her. And sometimes TikTok, TikTok's not reality, but also I've learned so much off TikTok.
So much.
And like, it does give you perspective. And if you've been in your bubble for so long where you're like, well, I work just as much and I'm stressed all the time. And
it's affecting your mental health.
Yeah.
I like, truly believe that women are not meant to work hard. I, like, this girl boss thing, I don't, I mean, like, do you? It's just not for me. And if I feel like women should not be shunned or talked down upon
if they want to
be a stay-at-home mom or if they just want to live the soft life, as long as, you know, it's okay in their relationship. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't see it as lazy. I think you are being in your feminine. As long as you're taking care of whatever needs to be done and you're taking on 100% of the household duties and stuff.
And I also think, like, when you girl boss, it's like, girl boss is not supposed to be girl boss forever. Like, you're supposed to girl boss and whatever and then, like, eventually not work. Like, you want a girl boss to get to a point where it's like, you can relax earlier than 65.
I want to know where they live because I think 100K, if he's making 100K, very...
It depends where they live because you can't live off 100K here.
No, yeah, exactly. That's why I want to know where they live. Yeah. She said we can move to the suburbs. We could downgrade our home, but he doesn't want it as a thing.
And it's like, why?
I know. It's like, why can't you do that? Is it because you really enjoy having a 200K like household?
Or there's like, a lot of comfortability, but it's like you said, I do think there should be some compromise. Like, very much, maybe she needs to take 2-3 months off. Like, recoup and like relax for her brain, and then slowly go back. Mm-hmm. You know, like, go part time or like pick up shifts where you can, like, or do what she was saying, but like, she can adjust how many clients she takes.
Yeah, she's like, burnt out maybe. And she's just like, I don't want this at all.
Maybe it's like a jerk reaction to like, damn, I'm so tired. And now I want nothing to do with this.
Yeah.
But he needs to like let her explore that and then also, like, take over for a bit, you know?
I agree. Yeah. And also, I don't like how he's not supportive at all about her.
I don't like that either.
About her thing. He doesn't want it at all. But it's like, why do you want your woman to be stressed? Why do you want her to like be working as many hours as you. And
you
like,
know what I mean?
You know, don't you want her to be more relaxed and maybe nicer to you, like cater all her time to, well, not all her time, but more time like to you.
It benefits you at the end of the day too. It is a lot for him to be asked to completely change his lifestyle. I do agree with that, because if you're mm-hmm. making from 200 and then now you're gonna go to half of that, your life will change.
Also for her though, mm-hmm. I just want her to know that like TikTok is not all, like
it's also
all
not the, true. Yeah,
yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like those are the highlights of their life.
Yeah.
You don't know what that woman living in the soft life is going through. You know what I mean? Like if it's actually as relaxing as it seems, because you are taking on a lot of the other responsibilities that need to be done,
it's also,
you know?
Hard too. Do you know that one girl on TikTok? She's like Amish or something. And she just like
makes cheese.
She makes cheese with all her kids like watching her and whatever.
Yeah.
So there was like controversy around her because it's like she looks like she just lives like a humble life. She makes her own food. They live out in like the middle of nowhere. Mm-hmm. Whatever, whatever. She turns out to be like, she's like a fucking billionaire. She
what?
Is.
What? Yeah,
I think either her or she's married to one of them is Slay. Like the son of like Delta. Like
the, oh, I like love the fucking that for her.
She lives the soft life and everyone's like, oh my god, like soft life, but like guys, you don't know, she's a billionaire living the soft life.
Yeah,
it's not easy to get, like, you know what I mean, like for you to like do nothing at all, mm-hmm. it is unrealistic. And like you cannot be 30 years old following what like this 22 year old girl is saying on TikTok. Like it's actually not realistic. And like unless you are a millionaire, mm-hmm. it's hard to have one income household, even like kind of regardless where you live.
What do you think about like the therapy thing, how she brought it up in therapy and wanted to have her own opinion about it before?
Okay, if he didn't know she was going to therapy, I do think it's a little betrayal, because I would feel that way too, because it's like, wait, I didn't know you were going to therapy and talking about me, like is everything okay, like why can't you discuss this with me, like, you know? And then like it's not that he wouldn't have been supportive to therapy, but if he knew she was going to therapy and she's discussing him, it's like, yeah, duh, like that's what I'm doing, like I'm in therapy, I'm gonna talk about my life, you are a part of my life. It depends, like that part wasn't really clear.
Mm-hmm.
So I would definitely be upset if my partner was secretly going to therapy about me.
Yeah, like, about our life.
About it's our life. Literally like our how life. Upset you are and like how, and how unhappy and all that stuff. So yeah.
Sprinkle has really an effect on every girl.
Is going too far.
Going to everyone's head.
Am I the asshole for blowing up on my son's girlfriend? My husband thinks I'm in the right, but my niece helped me make this post on here to see what other people think. I, 52 female, have three sons ranging from 13 to 20. My oldest son, 20 male, has a girlfriend, 19 female, that hangs around the house a lot. It's a really small house and doesn't have a lot of space. She's a nice girl, but she gets on my nerves sometimes because she's always over. I really don't think she's right for my son either. Our tap water has a weird aftertaste, so I ordered gallon water bottles and use them to refill a big glass bowl with a tap. Okay, it's not cheap to get water and other groceries delivered, so I tell my son's husband and the girlfriend to be courteous of the other people who live here and not use up the water as it runs out fast in our big household. Yesterday, I caught her filling up her big metal water bottle with the jug water, and I calmly told her that other people live here too and she shouldn't hog the water all to herself. She was rather straight with me and said something along the lines of, actually, this water bottle is big enough to hold all the water someone should be drinking in a day. I'm not hogging the water, I'm just trying to stay hydrated. I found her tone to be disrespectful and ordered her to leave. She scoffed and went back to my son's room. That's really when I got frustrated. I opened their door and told her she has to leave. My son got really angry with me and told me that my girlfriend didn't do anything wrong and why is it a crime for her to drink water? I explained that I ordered this water for our family to use, not leeches who hang around all day rent-free.
Oh.
My son's girlfriend got a little teary-eyed and left the room and out the front door without saying anything. My son told me that I was a major asshole and should have just minded my business. I think she's just a wasteful little brat. Am I the asshole?
How old is this woman?
52.
And she's 19?
And she's 19.
You are the asshole.
It's giving like weird, bitter energy.
Yeah.
Like, why are you actually going crazy over water?
Yeah, water is not that expensive.
Like even it's expensive, but like, okay.
It's really not though.
A water bottle. Like I'm looking at my Stanley. It is a big water bottle. Mm-hmm. But it's like
you're filling it for the day.
She probably is only gonna fill it up once. Yeah. And like maybe her son will drink some of it too. Like, you know what I mean? It's like a lot of water.
And it's water.
And it's water.
Like we're arguing about water.
Yeah, like and you're getting upset.
I get it.
About
it's
water.
Filtered water and you buy it specifically because your tap water
doesn't taste good.
Dirty.
Yeah.
But it's just water. Like we
it's not even
water
dirty. It's not
survive.
Even it's not even dirty. It just tastes funny.
Yeah, you are the asshole.
Yeah.
I also think maybe she did have a bratty response, you know? Because mm-hmm. that's still your boyfriend's mom. Like respect
some respect.
Due.
Yeah,
some respect.
Yeah.
Even if you do feel a little bit like you're annoyed or you're disrespected a little bit, I would still keep that level of respect just because she's the elder. You know what I mean? I don't know. Maybe I was just brought up that way, but
no, for sure,
you know,
because I can't imagine being like, this yeah, is the water like, I need for the day, like,
yeah, like,
for
sure, girl, shut
I,
up,
yeah, I honestly,
be respectful,
open the water bottle and put it right back,
yeah, and then storm into the room, like, in my house,
yeah, that's
you're not my
doing,
kid,
you're doing a lot, yeah, you're kind of doing a lot, but there's an edit, okay. So most people said, yeah, you are the asshole.
Yeah.
The edit says, thanks for all the comments. I spoke to my son about the issue and y'all made me realize that it was deeper than just the water. I showed him this post and explained that it's not her, it's me. I think she reacted that way when I initially told her off for filling up the bottle because, and my son helped me realize this too, I was never really nice to her to begin with.
Oh.
In the course of their 3-year relationship, in my defense, she only started hanging out around the house about 6 months ago because she got a license. We called her on the phone this morning and I apologized for my reaction to the bottle. I explained I didn't really mean to make her feel bad about the water. It really wasn't that big of a deal and I feel silly for making it a big deal.
Yeah.
She apologized for having an attitude and explained how she can feel a little defensive around me sometimes. I told her and my son that I'll work on my attitude. My husband still thinks she was being disrespectful, but I explained that I'm the reason she felt the need to act that way in the first place. It's not my choice who my son decides to date, and I need to respect his choice.
Yeah.
I think she is a sweet girl, and I feel horrible for the way I've been treating her.
I get how that could be annoying, even as at your big 52 age.
Yeah.
Someone just being in your house.
All
just
the like, time. You know, especially if like, the house is not big.
Yeah.
Like, girl, please
I would
go
be
home.
Annoyed, and you know what they're doing in that room.
Oh, my
it's
God.
It's just like, you get, actually, get out.
Yeah, please, like, you actually leave, have to have some you know? Respect.
So I get how, like, maybe she just had some.
Enough.
She had, like, she was already mad at her, you know?
Yeah,
or, like, not mad at her, but she
annoyed.
Definitely was annoyed.
Yeah,
that set her over there. I was like, don't fucking touch my water, bitch. Yeah.
you wasteful brat. Yeah. It's crazy.
All right. We okay, hope you guys. I hope everything worked. I hope I was in the frame. I hope these
Hello?
Mics work. Oh, my God. But
anyway.
Yeah, we hope you guys enjoy this. Don't forget to like, comment, engage with us, and rate us on Spotify. And follow us on
follow
TikTok.
Follow us on TikTok.
Cue the commentary.
Subscribe to us on YouTube.
Yeah.
Oh my God, we haven't done a reader write-in in a long time.
Yeah.
We should do that next.
Oh yeah. So email yeah. us. We will definitely be doing a reader write-in next episode. So cue the commentary podcast@gmail.com. You might be featured in our next episode.
Yeah. That's it. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.